I mean, they had animals have sex with women. Part of it.
Yeah,
bestiality,
all that.
Yeah, that's crazy.
And them
elongated
heads and stuff.
That's going to be a big surprise
when everything comes in. Yeah,
that's
what's
coming
in.
I can't wait.
You know, certain
people don't really understand what it is.
You know, this propaganda and stuff to get our minds and our kids used to the alien thing. They're good, they're going to help us, and they'll be enlightened.
Hey, but actually, let me tell you the truth about aliens. Because I know a lot of people try to say that aliens are demons. Hey, get the scripture. Get the chariot scripture. We're gonna hit you with some real knowledge. That's one of those. We're gonna go with it, that UFOs, put it that way. They're not demons.
I like USOs. That's more
than they're IFOs.
No one talks about
them. Yeah, they're IFOs. Well,
we know what they are. Identify.
Well, they can go straight from the air to the water.
They can go through
another dimension.
I'm getting into the flat earth.
Uh-oh, stay away from
flat
there.
Earth.
They can grow inside the planet Earth.
Oh, yeah.
Well, we're all being controlled.
What'd you say it was called? The conspiracy theory or the center of the sea? Some kind of
chariot? No, we found the chariot.
Listen to this right here. This is 2nd Exodus 13, I'm starting at 1. And it came to pass after 7 days, I dreamed a dream by night. And lo, there arose a wind from the sea that it moved all the waves thereof. And I beheld, and lo, that man waxed strong with the thousands of heaven.
The thousands of heaven. Remember the Lord said, you read in the New Testament, he said when he returns, he's coming out the sky with legions of angels. The whole holy host of heaven. The host of heaven.
The fire of the waters.
Well, that's those chariots, those UFOs.
Oh yeah, it's in Enoch too that talks about.
Yeah, Enoch, exactly.
Yeah, that's what you can't verify.
Check this out.
It's one of the deadly systems.
You seen the movie on with Will Smith. Independence Day. Yeah. Remember how it came out? Space to the atmosphere.
The big giant.
The cloud
and the fire. Okay. They got that out of the script.
Yeah.
And when he turned his countenance to look, all things trembled that were seen under him. Under him. Listen. Whenever the voice went out of his mouth, all they burned that heard his voice, like as the earth fell when he filled with the fire. Listen, and after this I beheld, and lo, there gathered together a multitude of men out of number from the four winds of heaven. This is doing more and more point. It's about to go. All the nations coming together to fight. Listen, from the four winds of heaven to subdue the man that came out of the sea. But I beheld, and lo, he had graved himself a great mountain and flew up upon it. But I would have seen the reason for place wherein the hill was graven, and I could not. And after this I beheld, and lo, all they which were gathered together to subdue him were so afraid, and yes, durst fight.
Well, like an Independence Day, how they showed the army, the air force is fighting against the spaceship. Right? That's what they're going to do when the Lord comes back. They think they can fight him. Go ahead.
That's why the governments in the world, they got their own. They got their own UFOs, too.
Right?
And a lot of them UFOs, they catch pictures of. That's fine. That's usually the governments.
Oh,
UFOs.
Yeah.
That's usually a lot.
Just
of
like
people.
That picture right there. That's
yeah, because they got
what picture?
They got
of Jesus. How he looks
like that. Let me continue. And lo, as he saw the violence of the multitude that came, he neither lifted up his hands nor swore nor any instrument of war, but only I saw that he sent out of his mouth as it were in a blast of fire. Now he's describing UFOs, you know, UFOs are windows, you know. blast of fire, and out of his lips a flaming breath. And when the Lord had out his eyes, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
And out of his tongue he cast out sparks and tempests, and they were all mixed together. The blast of fire, the flaming breath, and the great tempest, and fell with violence upon the multitude who was prepared to fight,
right,
and burned them up every one. That was a UFO, just like the UFO in the penetration above the building, shot that beam on it, vaporized everything.
Yeah, so like Randy Quaid was not going to go with me.
And fell with violence upon the multitude which was prepared to fight, and burned them up every one, so that upon a sudden and innumerable multitude nothing was to be perceived, but only dust and smell of smoke. When I saw it,
only dust. Only dust.
Where's that other one? Oh, yeah. Check this out. That will be your spiritual heart. Here we go.
What you doing, bro? Yeah, just don't touch my buttons. You're good.
I'm not.
Check this out. This is Wisdom of Solomon 5 and 1. Then shall the righteous man stand in great boldness before the face of such as afflict him, and may on no account complain. When they see
it,
they
cutting?
Shall be troubled with terrible fear, and shall be amazed at the strangeness of his salvation, so far beyond all that they look for. Like right now, we're talking about the Lord's coming in UFOs, right? Nobody looking for the Lord coming in on giant massive UFOs. You know, they think the Lord's just going to come through the air, like they sit on clouds, float through the air with some type of spiritual chocolate maker, sprinkling chocolate.
Fart glitter.
That's what they do, too. The Skittles commercials, the rainbow, scattered rainbow Skittles everywhere. You know? Yeah. They think the Lord's just going to be coming back with love. Love like that.
Hey, you know the story of the Ten Commandments?
Yeah.
Y'all know the story of the...
Yeah.
You know the story of the Red Sea?
Yeah.
Now what did it say? The scripture says the whole time the Israelites was walking around through the Red Sea, when they walked through the Red Sea, they had a cloud during the day following them, and at night it was a pillar of fire. The manna was the food.
Yeah, they were eating.
But it tells you there was a chariot guiding them through the wilderness. Yeah. Through the sea.
You ever been out west in like foreign parts, Nevada or wherever, at night, and it's dark as living? You know, and back then, when they were walking through that chariot at night, like the brother was telling you about, that chariot had to lead them that way. It was so bright, let them through that darkness, you know.
It's just like
that was a scary world back then.
Yeah. That star that you're talking about, Sir David, that could have been.
Imagine the lights go off now. It's going to be dark as shit out here. It's going to be sickening dark that you ain't going to be able to see nothing. We're so used to night lamps, headlights. Cell phones.
This is like when you see Columbus far off in the nighttime, it looks like hell. Really. All you see is light, looks like fire.
Yeah,
it's just
you can see it
from your
high up.
Hey,
check this
before. Okay. The act one is when the eight and four come together, the act of the man there, the action. What would you say? Why they've been held? Taking up and cloud receiving out of their sight. While they look steadfastly toward heaven as he went up, behold, two men stood by them. All right. Right, this was after the resurrection, after the Lord died and rose from the dead. He was up, chilling, talking to the disciples, right? And then it said he got received by a cloud, and he went up into the sky, and the cloud received him. That's when it was chariot. The scriptures also refer to the Lord's chariots as clouds.
Chariots of
the sun. Yeah, right.
Acts 1 and 9. And he had spoken these things while they were taken up.
You ever seen Star Trek? Beam me up, Scotty.
Yep.
You're on the planet.
That's on the planet.
That's a beautiful thing, man. But imagine witnessing it, though.
You still got it right
there. But check this out. There's more to it.
That's a beautiful thing.
Yeah. We pray to heaven.
When we come to those that get delivered by the Lord, we're going to go up.
Have you seen about that stuff with dark matter and light matter? What if you break through
and
all that?
It's crazy. Yeah, she's out there, boy.
It's crazy.
Yeah. That's something else, hey.
She you got to leave that one alone. You'll be on YouTube all night long, don't you?
Yeah, it drives me nuts.
I thought I recognized you.
It drives me crazy. Some of the stuff I wish everybody could look at.
Well, a lot of the stuff,
awake,
though.
Right.
You gotta,
I feel you there. Hey, watch a bestiality video.
Oh,
no.
I've seen them in the wild. I used to be a
shirtless. Okay.
Once you see it, your mind is disturbed.
Oh,
you see it,
dogs are more common. Yeah, dogs are more common.
Way more common. You know, America loves your dogs.
Listen to this, though.
Verse 11, actually, there's also saying, you men of Galilee, why stand ye gazing up into heaven?
Okay.
Yep.
The same outside of which is taken up from you into heaven shall so come in like manner as they have seen.
Same Jesus.
So he said he's coming back the same way he left, which is
stop.
Out the sky.
But that's kind of funny though. We say identify, but when he comes, man, these people unlearn them, they shoot them. You know?
They're gonna be scared.
Oh, shit.
The scripture says that every eye shall see him and their heart shall fail them. So people, they're gonna have a heart. Some people might see they'll have a heart attack against them.
Right.
Is this it's gonna be a scary day.
Zechariah 5:1. Then I turned
and
lifted up my eyes and looked, and behold, it was a flying robe.
Nobody knows, bro.
Now, he said unto me, what seest thou? And I answered, I see a flying robe. The lift thereof is 20 cubits, and the breadth thereof 10 cubits. Then said he unto me, this is a curse that goeth forth over the face of the whole earth.
Chariots, he's telling you that the UFO is going to be cursed.
What did you say? You said UFO, what?
UFOs, right. They're going to be a curse.
That's the angels.
It's going to be a curse.
That's the curse when you see a UFO.
But those are the angels because they're coming to bring destruction.
Right.
That's why you ever hear that song, demonic. Swing Low, Sweet Chariot.
So that's demonic?
Huh?
No.
Well, you know what? Yeah. To the wicked, this is some demonic thing. You know? Excuse my language, children. You know? He's not coming to save the wicked. You hear what I'm saying? Read again. Listen to the scripture. Just listen to the scripture.
Then I looked and looked up my eyes and looked and behold it, flying robe.
You see the UFO, a flying robe.
And he said,
listen.
And he said to me, what seest thou? And I answered, flying robe.
Because if you enter ufology.
So what is that? The flying thing? What is that?
UFO. Well, it's a chariot. It's an angel.
Angels. They're angels. You know when you see, you ever seen one? There was an angel. You see the angel.
Yeah,
that's all you see. You see the angel. No, ain't no such thing.
We're the fallen angels.
Yeah. We are all
that's
the fallen angels.
We know that.
Well, we just
falling angels.
But anyway,
this is our second sermon.
See, listen. The scripture says that even though we're telling people this, they're not going to believe it anyway.
Yeah, they don't believe it.
You know?
Hey, look.
Then said he unto me, this is the curse that goes forth over the face of the whole earth.
This is the curse that goes forth over the whole earth. They're going to surround the whole earth. Like the brother quoted the book of Revelation, that every eye shall see these things. The Lord has come with multitudes and multitudes of angels to deliver and to be a man. Because all of us got an angel around us, right? That we don't see. And those angels report back to the Lord. Your report card, judgment day, and that angel's gonna come, you know.
You've been here for
Isaiah 66 and 15. For behold, the Lord will come with fire and with his chariots like a whirlwind to render his anger with fury and his rebuke with flames of fire. For by fire and by sword will the Lord plead with all flesh, and the slain of the Lord shall be many. So he said his chariots come like a whirlwind. His chariots as those angels. They coming out and they bring a fire.
Destroy that curse, man. Go forth across the face of the whole earth.
When you've seen a chariot, you know our salvation.
Hey, check this out. This is the elect being delivered. Okay? And this is, you don't even need to explain this. It's just so self-explanatory. This is 1 Thessalonians 4 and 15. Listen.
I'm watching.
For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of the Most High, and the dead of the Lord, and Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together.
That same thing as Acts. How the Lord got caught, went up. Yep. We're going to do just like the Lord did. And he's going to take us up there with him.
Yeah.
We'll get beamed up.
Yeah, well, the
word rapture, you got this doctrine called the rapture doctrine, which is totally bugged out. But the word rapture means to take away. So there is going to be a taking away.
So blink the eye, we're all going to be.
Right, just like the scripture says, the twinkling of an eye will be changed.
Okay, let me finish. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord.
Skittles.
That's delivered right there.
Taste your rainbow.
Now, we're going to watch ourselves go. We ain't going to fall asleep and end up in a chair. We're going to watch ourselves go. And let me tell you something. I don't like heights. I don't like going up there looking down. But you got to go through it then. When you get delivered, you're going to go up, and you're going to go up high too. You know? You're going to be like going up. You're going to be praying, Lord, please don't drop me. Please don't drop me.
Oh, and then when you look down, you're going to see America look like a lake of fire.
Hey, missiles and missiles pass.
That's what the lake of fire is. The lake of fire is the destruction.
You and a missile going to pass. You're going to touch it.
Yeah. You're going up and a missile's coming down.
I have to put your sickness on, Lord.
That's really not funny.
Yeah, you know, hey, wicked's out of here. And it's funny to laugh at.
It is.
It's funny to laugh at the destruction. But we're over here pushing this word, they strong man up.
Hey, check this out. I got a scripture for you. Psalms 2 and 1. Why do the heathen rage and the people imagine a vain thing? Oh, Donald Trump make America great again. That's a vain thing. The kings of the earth set themselves and the rulers take counsel together against the Lord and against his anointed, saying, let us break their bands asunder and cast away their cords from them. He that sitteth in the heavens shall laugh. The Lord shall have them in derision. Then shall he speak unto them in his wrath and vex them in his sore displeasure. So the Lord, he said, hey, you know what the heavens of heaven is, don't you? Outer space. The scripture talks about outer space.
You guys are almost done.
You got multiple heavens. You have outer space. The clear blue sky. That's
heaven.
Yeah, I heard that.
Yeah, that's some crazy.
Pyramids on the moon.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Hey, face of a pharaoh or something.
And we only see one side of the moon.
Right, you can only see one side.
It's kind of weird.
So you into all the ancient astronauts, ancient alien stuff?
Not really.
But you know, you listen to a lot of, like, you mentioned Chariots of the Gods by Eric Von Däniken.
Yeah.
Like, but you'll notice some, all these guys have in common for their little theories to work, it will not work without them using the Bible. They always go to the Bible. You gotta watch a lot of these people out there teaching that ancient alien
you guys
stuff.
We
got Twitters and YouTube. We got like thousands of videos. Welcome to the Wicked, too. Yep. Hey, cause there's so much shit out there you can't compute. Yeah, right. So at least you're thinking. But there's so much crazy stuff on YouTube, man, you can get fucked up. And I mean that's why you gotta have that filter. Like you can't just drink water straight out the tap without cleaning. Taking the fluoride out and all the poison in it. But that's why we use the scriptures as a filter to filter all this information that's in the world. We take the information, filter it through the scriptures.
That's right.
You know what I mean? Man.
You can't take everything.
Yeah, you can't, like you said, flat earth and that flat earth is a danger. You gotta stay away from that. But they make it look so appealing, you know? It don't really make sense. But if we look at it though, I mean, people kept talking about it, so I watched hours and hours of videos on it. Hours of my life I can't get back. You know what I mean? Isaiah 40.
Yeah, but you look it up, it says cylinder. I have a fucking word.
Well, don't say it means compass. So compass is a circle. Well, some people say it means sphere too. So I mean, all they got is one scripture to use. But we can use that same scripture to say the earth is sphere. Right. If the earth was flat, the sun would never go down. It would just get smaller and smaller. Yeah, it'd be going around in a circle, getting small. That don't make no sense. Yeah, lay off that. The earth is definitely round. Even Ptolemy, the ancient Ptolemy, he was lived in the first century AD. He told you that the earth was round. It's a sphere. Yeah, Ptolemy. He's a famous astrologer. In the ancient world, because you know, like during the time of Christopher Columbus, they said he believed the earth was, everyone believed the earth was flat. That was bullshit. Nobody believed it. A lot of the old maps, Europe was on the bottom. It's like, I mean, it's just, they looked at the world. There you go. That flat earth thing was set up. to make conspiracy theories look stupid. Egyptian mythology is for real. All right, then hit me up on YouTube. If you got any questions?
Life for me.